mother of all tips on data sufficiency questions. If you are able to solve a DS question very easily, you are probably missing something. There is always a catch. Look for one. If you have not been able to find a catch, you are probably missing something. Let me explain this through an example. Look at this question. Highest common factor of four integers A, B, C, and D. Please try solving this. Now, 90% of the students get this question wrong, thinking that even on combining, they don't have the value of D and therefore the question cannot be solved. The answer should be option E. This is what I'm trying to teach, that if this were so simple, this would not be a GMAT question. There must be a catch somewhere. Look deeper, find the catch. If you're not finding the catch, you're able to solve the question this easily, you are missing something. Let me solve this for you. We have to find the highest common factor of A, B, C, and D. Highest common factor would be something that divides each of them. Now it says, statement 1 says that A is 27 and B is 49. A and B, what is the highest integer that divides each of them? The highest integer is 1. They don't have anything in common, A and B. So no matter what C and D are, the highest common factor is going to be 1 only. C and D are not needed. Statement 1 alone suggests that the highest common factor is going to be 1. Statement 1 is sufficient. Look at statement 2 now. It says B is 49 and C is 20. What do B and C have in common? Nothing. And therefore, highest common factor of B and C is 1. And no matter what A and D are, the highest common factor of the four integers put together is going to be 1. A and D are not needed. Statement 2 also suggests that the highest common factor of all the four integers is going to be 1. 1 is sufficient, 2 is sufficient. If you thought the answer is E, that's not correct. The answer is D. Remember the mother rule. If you are able to solve a DS question very easily, you are probably missing something. This was the concept, guys. GMAT shorts are deliberately kept brief. For an elaborate explanation, please refer the stage 1 videos. Thanks for watching.